My friend here has a thing. My friend.
I'm doing the Mr. Clean right now.
My friend had a thing right here. She's got a thing for bald guys, so hey, so you know, right?
I know, bald guys are sexy. You know, comb overs are so horrible. Men who dye their hair that look like shoe polish are very unattractive. And as a more mature woman, I was told today in French it's called un femme de sagesse, wisdom. I would rather you go bald and be your natural self.
There was a woman who I haven't seen in several years who once sung a song to me personally at a nightclub called I Love Them Bald. And she made me the focus of her... it was in front of like 50 people. I'm talking about sweating off the head
well,
here.
I think it has a lot to do with, to be honest, we live in a society nowadays that is trying to tell us we smell, we don't look good, we need makeup, men can't get it up. You know, the media is telling us everything.
Men can't get what?
You heard me.
not,
men can't get it up, but that does not apply to you, Zeddy. Not that I would know personally. But the point is that we live in a media society that tells our children that they're not good enough natural.
No children hope they can watch this.
And so I think it was Bruce Willis who really shaved it all off.
Yeah, he did.
And in a sense gave women permission, men permission to, you know, do their best look bald.
Actually, it was Michael Jordan.
And Mike, well, that might have been a, yeah, exactly. And so, and I think for women, people like Diane Keaton and Helen Mirren, there's some other women who don't go necessarily, they might do a few little things, but they don't look like their head's been pushed through a wind machine.
No.
And we don't know in America how to grow old gracefully or, you know, play up what we have. I'm not saying be unattractive. I'm saying be who you are and be the best you can be.
I look this way because I stopped working for Jerry Brown and I thought, what do I not like about myself? And I thought, I don't like that I have hair, so I shaved it off. That's how it happened.
What's your story? Well, it's either this or man bun. Everything else in the middle is just non-committal. That's the long and the short of it. Right?
Marla, thank you for saying that we don't look like giant you-know-whats, okay?
You guys are great. I mean, cool. I think it's, I know. And I also like that, and I'm hoping that we're working to the fact that we can be who we are. You know, if you want a man bun, whether I like it or not is irrelevant, get a man bun. If you want to be bald, be bald. I mean, but, you know, don't, before you resort to artificial means to enhance what you think is beautiful, really look at yourself. Because there was a study recently, and I'm going to close with this, that said that most men, if given a choice between a stick-thin model or a more Rubenesque woman, they would choose the Rubenesque woman every time.
I want a chick with muscle.
Yeah, because they feel like they're very fragile, not cuddly, not warm. And so, you know, and as a Rubenesque woman, I have never had a guy throw me out of bed because I was too heavy. So I'm here to tell you, ladies, keep yourself trim, keep yourself healthy, but if you're Rubenesque, own it.
Yeah. She's really here to tell you she's never been thrown out of bed.
All right.
Thanks,
okay.
Bro.
Thank you.